Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure here. YouTube playthrough. What a fantastic run that last one was, man. I'm gonna be honest, I wasn't too sure about it, but hey, we came through in the clutch. We also got ourselves a focus ring at the end of that run, which I'm so happy about. It's one of the best, if not the best, all-around trinket in the game, in my opinion. So, I was looking at this Berserk Charm. I'm not sure if I actually want to buy it or not. I do like the speed and the damage. The stress resist doesn't really worry me that much, but the problem is that we're going to be having a lot, and I mean a lot, of upgrades coming up. But I still think I am going to buy it, just because of the fact that we just need damage right now. Like, our heroes need to be able to do as much damage as possible. So let's see what we have here on the table. We've got the Hag Witch, which is the last tier of bosses. We've got our A-team. Our A-team is in the Sanitarium, I believe. Boogie, yeah, myself and Boogie are both going to be MIA here. So we've got H the Husky. Husky, he's finally come back. We need to push him over the edge to at least level 4, and I think I want to do that right now. So we have a 90% exploration on the ruins, or 100% rune battles in the Weald, which is how it's pronounced. Not Weld, apparently, but it's pronounced Weald. So we're going to be in it for a long haul here, going in for a long veteran mission in the Weald, and that is fine with me because that is going to be a lot of XP for Husky. The reason why, by the way, I'm so harping on getting Husky to the max level is because I really, really like Highwaymen in the game. I think that they are one of the best classes in the game, in my opinion, anyway. So let's get Trayson upgraded. I don't know if I'm actually going to bring Trayson with us. He does not have the self-heal. I don't think I'm going to need it. We'll splurge a little bit here. Jared, we'll go ahead and upgrade. I'm just randomly upgrading people. I don't know who I'm exactly going to play. By the way, I was not aware that I misspelled Gerard's name until like recently, so apologies about that. People were trying to tell me about that, and I do apologize that I missed that. Who are we going to bring in this run? That's the only question here. Miss Bone Kitty has been out of the rotation for quite a while. Where is Ro at? Ro is getting stress relief right now. Davis could go. Davis could definitely go here. TB could also go. Should we bring TB? We may actually bring TB here. Let's see. It would be Husky, I guess. Davis. I didn't realize that. No, I could bring Trayson. Trayson would need... Yeah, let's bring Trayson because we need a high level leper anyway. All right, so it's gonna be Husky, then Trayson. We could bring Jared, or we could bring Marie for extra damage. I think for a long mission, honestly, bringing Jared is probably the best idea, and then we'll bring TB for extra damage as well as, of course, the healing. So all right, let's get them all provisioned here. Absolutely, one Husky having the focus ring here, and we might as well give him a Berserk Charm, I guess. I thought we had the Highwayman trinket that had a proc of scouting. I guess we don't. Must be imagining that. What was the other highway? Here's something that I do wish the game included, was a sort command. Sort by rarity, sort by class, that sort of thing. That's not what I wanted. Yeah, I guess we're just not gonna have that. All right, well, Berserk Charm it is then. H the Husky, Husky, he gets one. Trayson, we can give him either the Brawler's Gloves, but we're gonna be doing a lot of bouncing around with Husky, so I think that we just give him a Berserk Charm, to be honest. And I am okay with that, because he also has the Fortunate Armlet, which is very good. So that will offset the damage penalty that he gets from the Berserk Charm. TB, Cleansing Crystal, absolutely. And we'll also give him a little bit of dodge as well with the Shimmering Cloak. And last but not least, we have Jay to the Era Jared, who I believe he needs... Does Jared need an upgrade? Oh, yeah. Jared's way behind on upgrades. Good lord. Yeah, we'll get Jared upgraded here in a second. I don't really care about the Death Blow Resist anymore, to be honest. I'd rather go for just... Stress resist and just protection, really, for Jared. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, let's go. Before we do this long, I mean, we are going to a long mission, even though we're over-leveled and over-geared for this. You never want to shortchange yourself. So we've used a lot of gold for this run. But hopefully it will pay out. It's possible that it won't. It's a very good chance that it won't. I did not upgrade TB's weapon, but that's okay. And Trayson's good. All right, so we're finally ready to go here. Since we are going into the wheel, there's a good chance that we can find food with the beast carcasses, but I'm not going to rely on that. We're going to bring three shovels. We'll bring three just to... That's fine. Two. I'll bring four. Why not? No torches, of course. I'm going into the wheeled. I don't know how that's pronounced wheeled, to be honest. If it was like W-E-E-A-L-D, maybe, or W-E-I-L-D. Or even W-I-E-L-D. It doesn't matter. How do you get wheeled out of that? Come on, English.
Corruption has soaked the soil, sapping all good life from these groves.
So Jared is going to be our trap opener. We have to do 100% room battles. This map actually is not that good. Given the fact that there's this long stretch of backtracking we have to do, we might camp extremely early. The only problem with doing that is that it's... Okay, I thought I just threw that away. I was going to be kind of upset. The only problem with camping early is that we don't have a lot of food. So, let's get it going here. Husky leading off with 23 damage non-crit. Pretty nice indeed. Might get a knockback here. Or we could just go for straight damage. Let's try a knockback. Did get the debuff of minus 10 accuracy, which is good. It's unfortunate that Jared is going second to last here, but what can he do? And TB can... Let's see, he can... I guess just go for damage, why not? Yeah, TB getting a crit. Blow. TB picking up right where he left off, man. I think bringing a Jester for a long run is a good idea. And rabies. Let the good times roll, RNG. Destroy. That's what Trayson has to say about rabies. So, for those of you who don't know, rabies actually decreases your accuracy, but increases your damage by a lot. And of course, we all know that leopards have the worst accuracy in the game. So, the fact that anything drops his accuracy, especially this early, is quite ridiculous.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
So I'm hoping that we run into an early beast carcass here, just so we have a chance. I'm glad that we came here because there is a room battle. And that is a terrible, terrible shift. Trayson literally can't do anything right now. Jared can at least go back to the back. So we've corrected it with two moves, but that's two characters that we just flat out aren't attacking with this run. Or this turn, rather. No crit from TB, that's okay. We don't bring TB for the crits, we bring him for the heals. Focusing on Trayson and Husky, which is fine. They did get the bleed, which is okay. Trayson able to hit even after the accuracy debuff, which is kind of surprising, to be honest. No kill, really. He's got one HP left, huh? Alright. TB should be able to get the kill here. Only problem now is that the Fusilier and the Cutthroat are going to be able to get their attacks off, which is unfortunate. They do a lot of damage. Unless they miss, then they don't do any damage. I actually would prefer Trayson did not kill either one of them, man. They did dodge. The reason why I want to do that, the reason why I say that is because I'd like to get actually some heals off with TB here. So he procs the bleed, but gets 18 on the heal. Huge heal from TB. Monster heal. Falls,
the faint hope blossoms.
And rush shot. Another nice dodge by Husky. I'm going to delay here. Oh, we did get the accuracy debuff. Nice. I'm going to delay here so we can get a heal on Husky. And another 18. Good lord, TB. It's two max heals in a row. Wow. I will take that. I'm okay with that.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
No food, unfortunately. It's okay. Hidden treasures, not really anything that we care about. I'm going to let Trayson bleed here. He's a leper, he can take it. I'd rather use the bandages for loot. So the question becomes, when do we camp? The reason why, by the way, I'm putting emphasis on camping early is just so we can get scouting. A higher chance for scouting from Husky. Rapid rush. Goes after Jared. I don't know if the leper has a survival skill that allows him to purge diseases. I don't remember if he does or not. No crit from Trayset, which is unfortunate. Still going after Jared. That's just stress damage. Unless he's gonna destroy one of the wolves here. Probably should use TB to kill the Gnasher. Luckily, Husky's gonna be able to go anyway, so not that big of a deal. And Jared could do, he could do some stress healing, but I don't think we need to right now, especially since we have two camping opportunities. Gonna get another heal off on Trayson. Not a very big heal there that time, TB, it's okay. 42 crit, man. Remember, Trayson's damage is buffed by 20% thanks to rabies. It's not necessarily a good thing or a bad thing, it's just a thing. We got more bandages, so I might as well use a bandage now. We got our bandage back, and this time... Oh, we got a map! That's huge. That is huge. So... Judging from... Wow. That's a... Judging from these close loot nodes, I'm going to go east here, because I'm hoping that one of the... That one of these... I mean, there's so many looting nodes here. One of them has got to be a carcass. I'm hoping that way we can camp here so we can start increasing our stats. And on top of increasing our stats, we can also give ourselves an extra chance of scouting. Not going to go with a torch. Obviously, we do get a little bit of extra food, which is actually kind of big. Husky destroy him already. I think we should go for a knockback here. I don't think Trayson can kill him. So if we can get an accuracy debuff... We do get an action debuff, very nice. And if TB can land another debuff, that'd be hilarious. Nope, he resisted the debuff. It's alright. Not a whole lot of stress damage. Decent damage by Husky. Nothing to really shake a stick at. Trayson, not able to kill the ghoul, huh? Nice dodge. I'd like to think that our debuff helped with that.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
Don't care. I don't even know what that bracer is, and I don't care, man. Don't care. We ain't got time for no bracers. So, all right, and yes, there is a carcass here, which is
the
good.
Darkness holds dominion.
The reason why this is significant black is because this will allow us to actually camp now. Well, it's not a lot of food. That's a disappointing amount of food here, we'll say. Let's go ahead and go after the remains here. More gold. I will get rid of the last bandage so we can take more gold. I can't good... Alright. So yeah, so we get a hunger proc right at the last second there, which is fine. And we're going to go ahead and camp now so we can start buffing each other. We really don't need to use 8 food. I mean,
a chance to steel oneself against the coming.
We don't even need to use 4, really. We'll just do 2. All right, Husky. Improved scouting chance. Absolutely. We also want to have him clean guns. TB, let's go for the strength. We're just going to go all in with Husky here. Reduce stress by 15 for everybody. I think that's a pretty good idea, Jared. And we can still do wound care if we want. Bandit sense as well. Might as well. Husky's being the all-around party man here. Look at the amount of buffs we've given him. 5 crit, 10 accuracy, 40% damage for ranged. By the way, the point blank shot does count as ranged, so that's the reason why I love point blank shot. We get ambushed. No real surprise there. Good dodge by TB. Oh, TB says ambush this. All right. Jared's gonna buff everybody up. Man, TB. TB is just, he's just solid. He just all around MVP of every single party he's in. Wow, a double 28 crit. Take a break, Husky. We don't need you.
Remind yourself that overconfidence
wow,
is a slow
that was
and insidious
impressive,
killer.
Team. Very
the
impressive.
Way is lit. The path is clear. We require
so of course we have 100. We have 100 light
it.
Because of the fact that we did camp. Doesn't matter if you have torches or not. It automatically sets your light to 100.
Be gone,
Husky with 38
fiend.
Crit. That was a melee crit, by the way. TB taking out the maggots, and this is an already over fight. Another good dodge by Jared.
Executed with impunity.
That's the reason why we wanted to camp. So we can buff up Husky. You get food out of that. That's fine with me, man.
Success.
That is okay with me. Don't know what I was expecting to happen there. Just thought maybe that there'd be a chance that we get some extra gold. I also don't know why we... Oh, no, we didn't scout that. Never mind. I don't care about the effigy. But apparently Jared does. What is making him do that so I know to remove that? I guess it's Hyromania? It's a little odd, though. Jared has a lot of negative quirks, that's for sure. We already took the anti-venom. Or we already used the anti-venom, so... Make room for the gold in the deeds that we got. Man, Trayson just going ham. What got into him? He does have rabies, right? Like, he does have, like, an ability to, like, a decrease to miss. But apparently Trayson just doesn't care that he's a leper.
A trifling victory. But a victory nonetheless.
It's unfortunate that we have not used this skeleton key. You know what? Getting rid of the firewood. We don't need to camp twice here. Take the portrait. Leave the gold. We spent so much gold, though. I can't throw away a skeleton. We have 3 skeleton keys that we haven't even used yet. We don't need to camp a second time. I hope we don't need to camp a second time. With Jared here, we should be able to curb any stress that we get. No crit this time coming in from Trayson. Guess we can't expect a 28 hit every single time. And TB goes for the one that has not attacked yet, which is a good idea. I'm surprised that Husky's the slowest out of all of us, this, even after the Jester buff. Yeah, Husky's the slowest one on the field right now, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. 57 crit. Wow. Those camping buffs, man. They're important. Let me tell you, they are important. Husky going to go again for the one that has not attacked. Unfortunately, he was just off of killing it. TB able to finish him off. I could have went for a heal there. I chose to go for the kill. Trayson's going to get the beat down. There you go.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can.
Man, I don't like leaving all this gold behind, but there we go. So I think that's just stress relief. We did spend a lot of gold to get everyone caught up on this, so I'm hoping to at least recoup, at least break even. We finally get an opportunity to use a skeleton key. We get a lot of gold, so I am going to throw away the final key. You would think that I'd throw away the medicinal herbs, but it's still very possible that we run out of food very quickly. Of course, we run into a room that has one final locked chest, so it's a good time to throw on that RNG. Oh, I was hoping Husky would get the one shot there. Now, the only problem with that is that it pushed Trayson out of the attack range. Really need TB to start healing here. And then shuffle TB back into position. Let's see, we can do a knockback on the big guy. Not debuff him, he also did not move him. Heal on Jared. Good sized heal from TB. Husky's able to take out the Fusilier, which is good. Husky's kind of in a bad spot here, though. He's the weakest one right now. And that is exactly what I'm talking about. So Husky's now bled.
Concentration.
And a point-blank shot, not enough to kill him, but we need to get a heal on him. We also have to hope that the bleed doesn't kill him. There's a lot of things that have to go right for Husky to not die here. We also have to hope that TB is able to get a heal and actually heal him for more than zero. All right, so Husky stays alive for now, but you see how it's just a hair, you're just a hair trigger away from dying and losing one of your characters. Another double crit, so Husky is again back on death's door.
How quickly the tide turns.
TB does save Husky again, but not happy with his RNG now. Getting a crit, but almost losing a hero is not worth it.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
We'll go ahead and take that. Let's have not Husky open the chest. Got more herbs, which is good. I'd love to. We've got 36 crests. I can't take any more crests. So again, I'm going to be looking for opportunities to get more food here.
The darkness holds much.
That's the reason why, right there.
Trickery.
You know, there's no fight in this next room, but we don't know what's in the next hallway. We did proc scouting, which is good. There is a fight, so we know that there's going to be another fight here. TB needs to really land these big heals here on Husky. 25 gold, huh? It's pretty big loot there. Unfortunately, we threw away our other logs, so we won't be able to camp, obviously. And they're still just keying in on Husky. He gets another bleed. Oh, come on, Trayson. You've been hitting everything, and now all of a sudden you can't hit anything? Husky's able to kill the Gnasher. Unfortunately, that's the one that already attacked. Gonna have Jared do a little bit of stress healing here. I'm only proc'd in TB. And they're still going after Husky, which is getting really annoying. TB got a 10, but the bleed is going to start stacking up really, really quickly. And yet again, they're going after Husky. Now is when the RNG starts to kick in, it seems. So we're going to have to fight for Husky's life here. Luckily, TB's not rolling zeros. I can't put Husky in front. I can't do it. Right, he's able to take out the Gnasher, so... And they're going to go for Husky anyway. Luckily, he dodged, because that could have actually put him on death's door again. 42 crit. There you go, Husky. You really, really need to get healed. Trayson's also not very... Trayson's not good. He's not well off right now. 17 heal. Huge heal from TB. And I don't care about confusion spores because they don't do a lot of damage. So Trayson gonna get the 45 crit. Very scary fight indeed.
Packs laden with loot are often low on
900
supplies.
Gold. Oh man. I can't get rid of anything. I really can't. I mean, this is 2,000 gold. This is 3,000 gold. Like, I can't take either of these. Even whatever's in this chest doesn't matter because we also can't take it. So, all right. Well, the long backtrack is gonna happen here, and we have to hope that we don't proc too many hunger scenes, because if we do, we have a chance of actually losing somebody and not completing the mission. So, yeah. I probably need to stop depending so much on the map generation giving us carcasses, like giving us opportunities to get food. But it always seems like the time that I don't bring anything is when I get everything. Like, I mean, the perfect example, of course, is the War in Thrones, where I just said, oh, yeah, we'll find it. We'll always find a torch. And there's like 1,200 scrolls in there, but we don't have one torch. Yeah, it's just bad luck all around. And then when I actually do take torches, what happens? We don't find a single scroll. I've already used that animal carcass, unfortunately, which it also did not yield a whole lot of food. So we have about made it to where we want to be. And judging by scouting, we're not going to get any food at least until this hallway. So I'm a little bit scared. We are now at RNG's doorstep with how fortunate or unfortunate we're going to get.
Mechanical hazards possessed by evil intent.
We gotta hope that we can find some food in the next hallway. He proc'd the bleed and got 4, unfortunately, so it's gonna be a... not even going to be a net positive. It's going to actually be a loss for Trayson. Trayson's going to have to, unfortunately, Trayson's going to have to go through, probably withstand here. I don't think we're going to be able to, unless he can kill the giant. He's going to have to get one heck of a crit to kill the giant. I think that it'd probably be better either using Intimidate or Withstand. I think Withstand's probably the better call here. That does give him protection in case of the, in case the giant does use tree Branch Smackdown on him. Poison Spores, it's fine. Don't really care about that. TB resisted it anyway. Now he can go for a knockback. And he resisted both. Oh, but Husky says, knock that. See you later. Down goes the giant. And TB can just get a heal here on Trayson. That'd be great. Proc'd another bleed and healed again for 4. So Trayson's now taking for 6 damage. And that's not good. That's enough damage to put him at death's door, actually. He's going to tick for 18 damage. And that's before the enemy starts attacking. So Trayson's going to be in a lot of trouble here. He's going to be in a lot of trouble. TB needs to stop proccing the bleed. I don't know how he has such a high chance to bleed here with the cleansing crystal. And he also needs to stop rolling 4s. TB, you need to have a really huge heal here. 10 is enough to maybe keep Trayson alive, just barely. No bleed. There we go. All right. TB saves Trayson. So much damage, though. Man. Trayson's still going to be ticking for another good amount of damage there. We do need busts. Busts are something we do need. I'm stunned that we've not had a shovel event. And of course, as soon as I do that, of course, we're going to get a shovel event. We all know that. That's why I can't take it. We need the food. We absolutely need the food. If we proc a hunger, that is very, very bad. That is not something that we can get food out of, unfortunately. I mean, it is, but it's going to be locked, so. We do finally get a beast carcass, which is great. So, it's just 4 food. Well, I'm going to hold out hope that we maybe get a little bit extra food. And at this point, hope is kind of fleeting for us. Let's see, if we can get a knockback on the ghoul, that'd be nice. Resisted everything. And a vulnerability curse does mark Trayson, but he does not get the debuff. Becomes the stress spam. And again, TB procs a bleed. These bleeds are really, really starting to add up on the damage here, TB. Not enough to kill him. Husky should be able to get him here. There we go. Maybe should be doing stress healing instead. All right, TB, heal yourself. All right, huge heal from TB. Nice job. Tops himself off, which is good. Fetid Cleanser is annoying because it does a ton of stress damage. I'm going to delay here for one round so we can get a little bit of stress healing and heal. Another proc on the bleed. You've got to be kidding me, man. I've never seen an occultist proc this many bleeds before with a otherworldly corruption. With a cleansing crystal. He's gonna get hit for 18. That's ridiculous. That is quite ridiculous. So we are down to the last hallway. And that's about the worst shuffle, because not only is TB out of healing range, Tracen is out of anything range. So we have a very good chance of dying here. Maybe not dying, but losing at least one person. Luckily, Tracen gets to attack before TB, but now they're going to go after Tracen. It's a lucky dodge. It's a mark on Husky. More stress. TB finally did not proc complete on Tracen. He's got a lot of HP to make up for. Now Husky's in danger. Man, we're getting a little bit hosed here towards the tail end of this long run. Need to start bringing everyone's stress down. We can't afford anyone's resolve to be tested at this point. That would pretty much doom this run. And again, they're going after Husky. And they're still going after Husky. Husky's on death's door now, with one with battery being able to attack. And a crit Tracen got the bleed, or got the blight damage on Husky, which causes him to go irrational, which means that he can actually kill himself.
Taken over the edge into madness.
So TB needs to save Husky right now. And Husky refuses the heal thanks to RNG. And then he dies. Unbelievable.
Set the stage for heroism.
Unbelievable. Well, that's good old Darkest Dungeon RNG for you. Of course, we would finish that after that happened. So we lost our only highwayman, who was on the verge of being level five, rather. Now we have to throw away a bunch of stuff just to get Husky's trinkets back, which I am very, very happy about. And if we have any luck, then we'll have one more room. Nope. So yeah, that's good old butthurt Darkest Dungeon in its finest forms. If I sound pissed off, it's because I am. Because we have to start over leveling a brand new highwayman if we want to beat the game properly. And that was all due to RNG. The RNG caused Husky to refuse TB's help. He was hit 3 times in a row and went irrational, which caused the RNG to have TB fail to heal. So yeah, I've got a right to be pretty annoyed right now. And no dungeon is worth completing if it means losing someone who's high level like that. Low level doesn't matter. High level at level 4, level 5, especially the way that happened, is ridiculous. So, gonna wrap it up. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you had more fun than I had on this episode, and we'll see you next time for more Darkest RNG. Until then, so long, everybody.